My fellow Info Warriors, this may be the most important video press release we have ever put out. But that is up to you. The destiny of this information is now in your hands. This is your mission to get the truth out and strike a serious blow against the New World Order if you choose to take this mission on. You know, I told you on ClimateGate back in November 2009 that it would be a death knell to the green fraud takeover of our entire economy by the internationalist. And the word got out, and now that entire program is in flames. This is just as big, and I'm about to explain why. Sarah Palin, back in 2008, was interviewed at a campaign event by We Are Change Ohio. And We Are Change asked her if she supported a new 9/11 investigation that the victims' families were calling for. And she said, yes, I do call for a new investigation of 9/11, which six of the 10 9/11 commissioners do. The head counsel, Mr. Farmer's, come out saying the whole thing's, quote, a criminal cover-up. The Pentagon was hiding what really happened. Why didn't we go after Saudi Arabia, where the supposed hijackers came from? Why did NORAD stand down? The list goes on and on. But the point is, Sarah Palin said more than gubernatorial candidate Deborah Medina did. She called for a new investigation. Now, why is that important? Let me explain this. You saw Brown in Massachusetts take away a Democrat-controlled seat that the Kennedys had held forever in a Democrat-controlled state, sending a message to Obama, the banks, both parties, we are sick of incumbents. We are sick of the establishment system looting and robbing the people. We want lower taxes. We don't want higher taxes. But with Deborah Medina in Texas, the second most populous state, you have a Ron Paul in the fetter, anti-New World Order person who will end the North American Union, who will defend our borders, who will get rid of unconstitutional gun laws, have opened right to carry like Vermont. This woman is a masterpiece. She will end the property tax in our state, which polls show over 80% of Texans support. She was gaining on average 5 points a week. She was overtaking Kay Bailey Hutchinson, the Bilderberg pro-bailout globalist. She was in just a few points of Rick Perry, guaranteed to be in a runoff. The Democrats are nowhere in the polls. If she can win the primary, she will be the next governor. That was being watched by the rest of the country. 30 plus states moving to nullify unconstitutional federal laws, declare 10th and 9th Amendment state sovereignty. The whole world was watching, not just the United States. And Glenn Beck, this fake conservative Judas goat who attacked Ron Paul in 2007 when he was close to getting the nomination for the Republicans, the guy that supports the banker bailout, the guy that supports new value-added taxes and sales taxes to pay the bankers, the so-called conservative we can trust, the guy that says use the army against Ron Paul supporters and other bizarre statements. This guy got Medina on, and we've now learned from Medina's campaign, cut her audio off, asked, what do you think about 9/11 truth? And then turned her audio off and she said, well, I support people's right to call for whatever they want. People have free speech in America. Nothing compared to Sarah Palin in the video you're about to see. And there are several others out there where she said, yes, I want a new investigation. Yes, I support the victims' families asking for one. 84% of Americans in an Angus and Reid New York Times poll said they don't believe the official story. What are we, all evil kooks? The point is, he now called her yesterday, on the 16th of February, it's now the 17th, a flat earther. He said Deborah Medina is a demon. You've got to support Rick Perry, the North American Union highway guy, the person who raised all these new taxes, passed a franchise tax, a business tax, that's really an income tax in Texas. The guy that is a globalist, the guy that Karl Rove helped get into office. And so he's hanging on the ropes, and Sarah Palin and Glenn Beck and others start promoting Rick Perry, because they can't have a true populist, a true constitutionalist, who's on the right side of history and who's popular with the people win, because that sends a message to all the other states. So before we play this video for you to see, the Texas newspapers and TV declared that Deborah Medina was politically dead and that her campaign was over. Within 35 minutes of Deborah Medina being on the Glenn Beck show and him mischaracterizing what she had to say when she only agreed with Sarah Palin, they had robocalls, the computer calls, on Kay Bailey and Perry going out to Republican voters. And Perry and Kay Bailey put out press releases of how evil and horrible it was, and how she was attacking the victims, and how evil it was, and how horrible it was. Meanwhile, their golden girl, their savior, is saying more than Medina said. And the week after they did this, her contributions doubled, showing that people see through the front. But still, a lot of Texans and Americans think, well, I'm going to vote for a winner. If they say she's dead, I don't want to waste my vote. I don't like Kay Bailey, so I'm going to go for Perry. It's all about perception. But the truth is, if you can contact all the TV and radio stations, and it's all over the web, who've been attacking Medina for simply saying, well, I support people's right to call for a new investigation. I don't think 9/11 was an inside job, but the commission has had questions. That makes her a flat earther. Meanwhile, Sarah Palin's calling for a new investigation, the same thing that Deborah Medina's saying. Meanwhile, the Democratic candidate, the front runner, he says it's probably an inside job. He says he doesn't know what happened.
Do you think it's possible, it is possible that the United States government was somehow involved in the 9/11 attacks on the United States?
Look, I mean, we still don't know who killed John F. Kennedy, you know, who's behind it, let's put it this way. Would we ever find the truth about 9/11? That's a very dangerous subject to get into, you know, so it's hard to make judgment. I'm not saying yes or no, because I don't know the truth.
But notice the media isn't covering that much because he isn't a threat. He's establishment. They want Perry in. Think about what's going on here. If you contact all the media and send them this clip and point out the hypocrisy, then the darling of the Tea Parties, the lady that says she believes global warming's real, the lady who supports John McCain, he's about to be kicked out, the anti-gun, Keating 5, pro-banker bailout, corrupt senator, she's there trying to prop him up in Arizona. She's here rushing like the cavalry to save Perry. She's the big savior of the mainline Republican Party and the Tea Party Nation that took over the true populist grassroots nonpartisan Tea Party. If you can point out the hypocrisy and the corruption and the fraud of the fact that it's been known for several years that she supports a new investigation, why is Palin a goddess, a god, but Deborah Medina is bad when Palin calls for the same thing? I'm telling you, this could blow up in their face in a way you can't imagine, but it is up to you. We're going to put on screen the original PrisonPlanet.com article. We Are Change Ohio broke this, gave us the video. You'll see our video link there, our website link. Sarah Palin supports new 9/11 investigation. Alaska governor gives unexpected answer during Ohio rally. It is up to you to contact all the major newspapers, all the major TV stations that have declared Deborah Medina dead. Now, their hoax of saying she was politically destroyed and that it was a fatal wound politically is a fraud, but it did slow her down a bit. But if we can get this story out and show the fraud and hypocrisy, it is over for them. Ladies and gentlemen, contact all the radio and TV stations, put out your own press releases, and get this news out that Glenn Beck, this hypocrite, sets up Deborah Medina, turns her audio off, and implies she's a 9/11 truther, when on her own website she said she's not. And then Sarah Palin's over here saying she wants a new investigation, and that's ignored. If you get this story out, we can get Deborah Medina elected. It will send shockwaves across the country. More true pro-liberty candidates will get elected at the legislative level, at their state houses, at the gubernatorial level, at the city and county level, and at the congressional level in Washington. And we can have a true peaceful revolution and take this country back. The globalist agenda is on the ropes. They're in trouble with their swine flu hoax. They're in trouble with their global warming taxing hoax. They're in trouble with their war hoaxes. They're in trouble with their government takeover of healthcare. They are in trouble. Tyrants want you to think they're invincible. They're not. But again, I'm just Alex Jones. Sure, 100,000 of you will watch this in the next day or two. The question is, what will you do? You have the power. Take action. Ball's in your court. Destiny and history is in your hands.
Victims, family members, and first responders of 9/11 that are calling for a new investigation. Thank you so much.
I do, because I think that helps us get to the point of never again.
Absolutely.
And anything that we can do still to keep that reminder out there.
Thank you so much.
Were you offended?
friends that were affected. I know people, and a lot of them are still sick and dying from the EPA because they lied about the air quality of that. Thank you so much, Sarah.
Thank you.